Hey Charles, what's up, man?
What up, Mike?
Hey, how do penguins build their houses?
Oh God, how?
And glue them together.
I knew that was coming. I knew it. I knew it.
So, Carrie Underwood on this fine morning.
Carrie.
Is she the sexiest country singer?
Either Carrie Underwood or Miranda Lambert.
Yeah, she's not very hot.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. It is Charlie here, and we're still doing mornings with Mike, but we're going to reverse the roles a little bit. I'm going to start this one off, and I'm going to let him ride my coattails today.
Ooh, give it to me, baby.
All right, Mike, so I got to ask you this. What kind of a weird addiction do you have? Like, are you addicted to always doing one thing every day or something like that?
So, something that I do.
Masturbation doesn't count.
Nah, I don't masturbate anymore. I'm married.
So he does it three times as much.
Honey, hint, hint, hint. Dude, I'm sleeping on the couch for the next week. I'm not even going to lie about that one. So scratch that. We'll try to edit that out. I'm just kidding. I don't edit shit out. Fuck that.
Editing's for the newbies.
So I pick scabs. I get cut like on a nail. See a nice big goosey like brown black scab. I gotta pull that bitch off. It's like, oh yeah, baby, give it to me.
All right. So that's a little messed up, pulling scabs on people. Me,
my... no, not on people.
Oh, just on you.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. That, so you just ain't walking up like, let me get that.
That would be fucking weird.
Okay. All right. So my weird addiction, I'd say like every day I wake up and I gotta go like straight in the shower. That's my thing. Like I gotta get up and get in the shower. I don't know what it is. It's like when I sleep, I just
you get that get under cheese happening.
Yeah. So. What, reading the internet, our lovely friend the internet.
On the interwebs. Lay it on me, Charles.
I was hearing a story, seeing a little video clip. Everybody's seen the show Weird Addiction. There's a lady who eats her husband's remains. Not like the physical body. She ain't like cannibalizing this.
So she got her like cremated, and she's like pulling ashes out of the...
He was cremated, and her whole thing about it was she was moving the bag from like a cardboard box into like an actual urn. And got some on her hand. She didn't want to brush away her husband. What a lovely lady we're talking about here.
I mean, he's already dead, so like I don't want to see him be peaceful.
Dust in the wind. No more dust in the wind. This is my boy, Blue. Anyway.
Wow. Old school.
Yeah.
Anyway, shout out Will Ferrell.
So she has it on her hand, and without missing a beat, she puts it in her mouth. And ever since then, according to her, it's about 3 to 6 times a day. She eats her husband's ashes.
Mean like, I don't like licking like mayonnaise off like on my fingers because like I'll be worried about what people think. Like, oh, there's some white shit on her finger. Let me. I mean like back in my day, I'd be like, fuck whatever, I don't give a shit. But like now, I'm like, man, I don't know where the fucking mayonnaise has been. Like,
is it clean mayonnaise?
Right,
has that mayonnaise been tested lately?
Like, is it because I'm a vegan now?
I'm sorry.
I'm just kidding. I fucking love the meat in my mouth all the time. Put that baby deep in there and let me.
My thing about this whole thing is she's eating her husband. Like a fucking fun dip here with her finger.
Right. So, I gotta ask you, like, is she putting like chips and salsa in it, and she like sprinkles some shit in there? Like,
no. From the video, she's like sitting in her car. She'll just grab the box, put it on her lap, open it up, lick her finger, dip it in there, take it out.
Speaking
like,
of which,
rub it on her
fun
gums.
Dip is a fucking amazing candy.
Oh,
I fucking
definitely.
Love fun dip. That's just straight sugar straight into the nostrils.
But this lady's fun dipping her husband. Like, what's she going to do when she eats it all? Like, it's going to happen
one
day.
Yeah, like, I'm going to ask you that. Like, is she going to get married again and murder that guy off? Like, hey,
I need you to... my supply here.
I need you to be my blood sacrifice.
Don't worry, baby. It's only hot in here because I'm making it hotter. You're going to be...
Zozo at work.
But, man, like, weird addictions. Like, I've seen some stuff on there, like the chick who eats deodorant or the one that eats her hair or whatever. But eating a cremated person like that is
pretty weird. One of the strangest ones I saw was a girl would eat in the fucking cushion like out of a couch.
Yes.
She would so like you know when you guys sit on a couch, there's a cushion there. She would like take that cushion and she would unzip the zipper and like just fucking eat it like popcorn. It was really fucking weird. And I mean, if I remember correctly, that like the doctor was saying, like, if you don't stop this, like, you're going to die because there's some type of chemical in the cushion.
The chemical in the cushion, and it was starting to cause a bowel blockage.
Yeah, it's, I mean,
your body can't.
I can't shit. That down. Well, because there's fucking foam in there soaking the shit up.
Like, because you're the new lazy boy. Shut up. Sit down. We're cutting you open.
Speaking of lazy boy, I love that movie. Basketball. Like a little side note. I saw that a couple of weeks ago.
Like, it's just getting up to that part.
No. Like, I've seen it like back in the 90s when it first came out, but it was it's on Netflix right now.
Oh, so I know what I'm watching later.
If you guys are missing, like, if you haven't seen Basketball, you guys are missing out. It's a really good movie, actually. I don't even know who the fuck's in it, but it's
the creators of South Park. Like, the original three guys are the main three characters, and those three guys do all the voices for South Park.
Interesting. So, yeah, girl eating ashes. That's fucking weird.
Chick eating her husband's. I mean, that shows some real love there. I mean,
no, it means you're fucking dumb.
I mean, she's obviously crazy. There's something, like, chemically wrong with her, but.
I mean, like, I go camping a lot, and, like, we're roasting marshmallows and shit, and you know, you get drunk at in your camping, and like the marshmallow touches the log.
Yeah,
I don't fucking eat that marshmallow because the fucking ash is gross.
Yeah,
like it's
Now imagine this: that's just a little bit on there. This chick is dipping an entire finger in there. Like, let me get a scoop of that and throwing it in her mouth. It's almost like she's putting a chew in her lip of freaking her husband's ashes. Like that is.
It would be kind of like. I'm kind of on a movie tangent now. Like the water boy, what part of the body do they think we're eating right now? but she obviously says snake, but like.
No.
I think it's his knee.
The coach asks, what part of the snake are we eating right now? Well, snakes don't really have body parts, but I'm going to say his knee. Like, come on.
How long do you think she's been doing it? I mean, like, how long has her husband been dead?
I think the video said something like her husband's been dead for like a year or two, and she's been doing it since then 3 to 6 times a day.
So like I kind of want to see how much of the ashes are like, you know, started out and see how much left, just to kind of calculate of like how long
she's been doing it.
Yeah, well no, like how long it will take her to finish it off.
Oh,
and then if she finishes off, duh, she graduated to like killing a dog and like I mean, because like, think about it, like I gotta think of it of smoking a cigarette.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, like once you finish your pack, like you just aren't done. Like you go out and you get
another one.
You get some more because you're addicted to it. So if you're addicted to eating your ashes, like do you graduate to killing a dog and getting the dog cremated or? Finding a dead raccoon on the side of the road?
Or better yet, what does she do if she's out in public and forgot the box in the car? Does she walk up to the guy smoking a cigarette? Hey, can I get that when you're done?
Let me get some of that ash.
Just right in the hands. Just right in the hands. Come on, right here.
I mean, like, I kind of want to bring this woman on, just talk to her.
I mean, I kind of want to talk to her, too, but I'm afraid she's going to throw me in a crematorium.
Well, no, we'll definitely do it, like, over the phone or, like, Skype. I don't want her anywhere near me.
Or knowing where we live.
That would be fucking weird, wouldn't it? But I'm just trying to wrap my head around this, like...
That's a weird addiction. Like, that is one of the weirdest things I can think of somebody doing.
I mean, that's kind of like, oh, I got shit on my finger. Or, like, instead of, like, going and wiping it off, like, I'm going to put it in my mouth. Like, then do you get addicted to eating shit? Like,
that just sounds like one shitty situation.
I'm just like, Charles, like, I legitimately cannot wrap my head around. I mean, like, there are some fucking strange addictions out there, like eating the couch cushions. Like I saw one where the woman was eating chalk.
Yeah.
And, like, she liked the flavor or the color chalks better than the white chalk. I don't know chalk had flavor, but whatever. It's
chemicals.
Eating the chalk, eating the couch cushion. There are some others, but like, I mean, they haven't been like been that weird, I guess. Coming from a weird guy myself, I don't know. I mean, just like that's got to be definitely.
Oh, that's like my question is like. I didn't see him talk to any of her friends or her family about the situation, but how do you think they feel?
She probably doesn't have any friends.
And she might not have any family. That's why she has an endless supply of ashes.
I mean, like, what if she didn't get the right cremation? Like, what if it's like, you know, like what if it's some Chinese guy? And
does it taste like lo mein?
Like the guy that had the dicks, right? But speaking of that, if you guys are not listening to Barbershop Talk, shout out to those guys, Gator and Holmes. They're on iHeartRadio too. Gator actually had some tiger dick while he's over in Korea, huh? And he said it's pretty good.
Nope, can't say I want to try.
Do you think the tiger dick tastes like the ash dick?
Hold on. Do you think that woman takes the ashes, put them in her hand, and go, "Look, baby, I gave you a blowjob."
That's fucked up, Charles. That's fucked up, man.
Oh, I am mentally fucked up after this one.
That's really fucked up. I'm just. I don't know.
There's no way to wrap your head around this because, like, this has been bothering me since I found this video. Like, trying to figure out, like.
So guys, if you're watching us on the YouTube channel, in the comments, tell us what your strangest addiction is.
The stranger the better. We won't call you out by name.
No, like, I will actually have a conversation, like, with you. And if it's really fucked up and it's true, because, like, people's like, oh, I do this, fucking show me. So if you do have a strange addiction and you have a video of it, go ahead and send me the link. There is a in the description, there is a link there where you can send me a little clip, and then we can watch it and we'll review it. And if it's really fucked up, man, let's have these people on. Like, do like
you know, we're about to probably get some chick with like a frozen hot dog stuck in her or something with these videos. I'm just saying.
I'm fine with that.
Me too.
Speaking of which, guys, on March 8th, I'm not for sure when this podcast is up. I believe it's going to be March 6th. But on March 8th, we're doing a YouTube Live. We're going to show you a little behind the scenes of what we do here. We're going to have a couple friends. My man, Chris Ho, if you guys remember Chris, he is from earlier in season 2. And I got a couple guys from work. It's like at work, Charles, like, we have some fucked up conversations.
That's every workplace.
So why not have a couple beers, have some pizza, and do it?
Oh, I'm calling off of work for that night. I will be here.
And we
will be live questioning you. Send us questions. Send us little comments. Like, we will be communicating with you guys directly.
Yeah, and I was introduced to this Reddit thing. It's called Reddit 5050.
Oh, God, I don't like this already.
It's like Russian roulette, and, like, the title will be like, two kittens playing balls, and it is just a link. So you click on the link, and it could be the kittens playing with balls, or it could be fucking like child, like some big black dude pounding some skinny white chick.
Oh, this is gonna get interesting and good.
So we'll definitely get some of that happening.
Definitely getting an Uber home that night.
So I don't know. Strange addictions. Woman eating her ashes. That's fucked up.
I mean, you got to do what you got to do to get through, but there's other things you can do to get through.
Go ahead and send us out, Charles.
All right, guys. Like always, you can find us on YouTube, Twitter, Speakerbox, Apple Podcast, Google Podcast. Y'all have a wonderful day and see us next week or next 2 days from now. Yeah.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
On your stomach.
Okay.
Okay.
Really? This song? Okay.
Right. It's random, bro. It's random.
Place my palms up.
Talk about a chick eating her husband, and now we're listening to something right on your stomach.
Like, we're going to let the song play. Fuck it.
I'm in.
This song's called Chili Rub by Stevie Stone and Tech Nine.
That I'm talking about.
More chili pimples popping now. Hey! I'm giving you a chili rub, and I'm feeling beautiful. You're loving what the milli does. Just a little minute longer with the rubbing. It is nothing. You'll be begging me to hit you with the billy club. I'ma do it. You wanna do it, some ashes, you gotta release that fluid. Spew it. Tell me, let a friend that never knew it. View it. Did you hella proper? Now you it. Do it. Yeah, she running like a relay. Meaning she quick when it hits D-Day. Like 180 on the freeway. You ain't gotta worry about a thing, nigga. She lay. Chili rubbing to get you hot as an oven. Whether you drinking or drugging to get you ready for loving. After you grubbing the muffin, you're gonna be shoving and stuffing. Nigga, you beating and busting like a percussion. Nigga, it's on if she take off her top. Shivery's making her get the riot, make it to pop. Shake her. Every time he says the N-word, it empowers me.
But you can't.